Hey, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Ronan Levy, the Executive Chairman of Field Trip. And Ronan, it's great to see you. How are you doing?
I'm doing very well. How are you?
I'm doing very well. You have a very interesting clinic situation here with your company. Maybe you can kind of take us through a little bit about sort of the origins of Field Trip.
Yeah, absolutely. So the founders of Field Trip actually came out of the Canadian cannabis industry. We had started two sister companies, Canadian Cannabis Clinics and Cannabis RX, and they have grown to become the largest network of cannabis specialized medical clinics in Canada. We sold part of that business to Aurora Cannabis back in 2016 and helped Aurora really grow from a small company to one of the largest producers of medical cannabis. After we left Aurora, we were looking for the next great opportunity, and that's when we discovered what was happening in psychedelics. It was still very nascent at the time. It was about 2 years ago now. And as we researched the potential of psychedelics and their therapeutic applications and just how profoundly effective they could be, we realized this is something that we wanted to get involved with. So we started doing some research and realized that when it came to psychedelics, one of the biggest challenges to making these therapies available to people was building the clinical infrastructure that's needed to really support this kind of care. And so that's when we embarked on Field Trip. Now Field Trip has grown to be something much more robust than just a clinical rollout. We're also working on drug development as well as some of the cultivation and research considerations around psilocybin producing mushrooms, which may have a path to market as well. But we're certainly starting with Field Trip Health Centers. Our first opened in Toronto in March of this year, and we're hoping to scale up to 75 locations across North America by 2023.
Ronan, who's right for this? What type of person do you think is treated for this? Is it depression? Is it PTSD? Those and others? What sort of people are you looking at to treat in the clinic?
Yeah, so when it comes to psychedelics, I think the thing that's most exciting about psychedelic therapies is their potential applications to just about every person on the planet. You know, whether you're dealing with a mental health diagnosis like depression or anxiety or PTSD, or whether you just want to see the world through a new lens and increase empathy and creativity and general well-being, it really can apply and be meaningfully beneficial for so many people. That being said, our focus is starting on the medical applications of psychedelics. And in our Toronto clinic, we will treat anybody who has treatment-resistant mental health conditions. So that can be depression, anxiety, PTSD, eating disorders, anything that kind of falls into that bucket of mental health conditions, because that's really where the research lies, specifically around ketamine-assisted psychotherapy, which is the treatment that we're starting with until such time as other classic molecules of psychedelics like psilocybin or MDMA get approved or legalized.
Ronan, I'm interested to know about the trying to convince people that this type of treatment can be good for them, because we've been sort of trained throughout society to say that if you're feeling something, you take a pill for it. You know, it's some sort. But then we've seen the obviously opioid crisis around the world and what that's done to people. So how do you sort of convince people, especially on the medical side, that this is something that people need to look at? And I know there's been a lot of research done over the last, you know, especially over the last year or so about the advantages to using something like this in a more natural setting. But is there still that need to kind of tell people, hey, this is, if it's done in the right dosage, this can be a real advantage for people to use?
Yeah, there is still some stigma associated with psychedelic therapies. I think certainly the experience with cannabis and cannabis medicine over the last 5 years across Canada and the US has really opened the door to the conversation being much easier, because people realize that once stigmatized medicines, once political held views were subsumed by the data, people really opened their mind that to be shown, when they were shown that it's safe and effective, it really shifted things. And that started with cannabis. With psychedelics, you know, the conversation's that much easier because the evidence is there. The evidence is better. You know, so it's, I think cannabis really opened the door and made people more receptive. And then when you provide the evidence and the data that exists, which is pretty robust, but getting better every day, the conversation has become a lot easier. It's easy in our world to get caught up on it, get caught up in it, and think that everybody knows this already. So really, it's just a function of education and make sure people know the data. But, you know, these days, it seems like the media is doing a great job of driving this conversation into the mainstream. So that's certainly doing our job for us to some degree. But we're still very active and holding continuing medical education events for physicians and family doctors, so they know what's going on within the psychiatry community. I think it's more understood and more accepted already, but with family doctors who are already so busy, you know, it doesn't always make it to the top of their list in terms of their need for understanding. But as mental health conditions become more prevalent, as they become more complex, certainly the pandemic isn't going to make things any easier for them. I think people and family doctors and GPs are really opening their mind to alternative therapies like psychedelics. So it's coming, but, you know, there's a little bit of a hurdle to overcome still.
Let's talk a bit about the revenue model for the company. I know you're introducing an online platform as well. So tell me a bit about the revenue and how you get revenue through, is it basically through the clinics?
Yeah, exactly. So we're building an integrated model, which means we really want to control the entire experience from drug development and product development all the way to the clinical delivery of care. And there's many steps along that road. We just launched our drug development platform in the last couple of months under our field trip discovery division. But for the foreseeable future, the revenue in our clinics is going to be generated by providing clinical care to patients. We're starting off because these types of therapies are not conventionally covered by most insurance programs in Canada. It's not covered by the public health insurance in the US. There's no uniform health insurance, but with psychotherapy, typically reimbursable under most extended benefit plans in Canada and in the US as well, and under private insurance, the cost of the care can be substantially reimbursed by existing plans. So a course of treatment in our clinics, which involves 16 sessions between the therapy, exploratory therapy, the treatment sessions, as well as the integration therapy, because we're really invested in it being drug catalyzed psychotherapy, not a pharmacological solution in and of itself. The 16 sessions cost about $4,700. So it prices out at about $275 to $300 per session, which is pretty consistent with, you know, psychotherapy services, particularly with clinical psychologists and all that kind of stuff. So we've really tried to price it in a manner that, you know, I recognize it's not an insignificant expense, but when you consider how, you know, typically psychotherapy can be a years long commitment that people do often, the pricing is pretty consistent. And when you look at the data, especially around ketamine assisted psychotherapy, which shows that people can be depression free or anxiety free for weeks, if not months, following a course of treatment, the costs actually become potentially much more economical than the historic treatments that people have used.
Yeah, very much so. Oh, Ronan, I appreciate the time. Thanks so much. Good luck with everything. And I know we'll talk again real soon.
It's been my pleasure. Thank you for having me.
All right. Ronan Levy, the executive chairman of Field Trip.